day one, we hiked about 12 miles along a ridge to Bearpaw Meadow.
I think for me, the highlight of day one was seeing we actually saw a black bear. Jenny made some comment about some kind of weird thing in the trail, indicating there was a bear, and I said, look, there's a bear. And I think Jenny and Kurt thought I was joking, and they turned, and sure enough, there was a black bear.
Huge campsite. We had all this space to ourselves, logs all the way around, a fire ring, and we made pizzas the first day. We had P&Js for lunch. I had a lot of fun putting the menu together, so I had an Excel sheet with all the calories. We were trying to get between 2,500 and 3,000 calories each day for each person.
Day two was, for me, I think, the toughest day. My bag felt so heavy. It was like 10 miles uphill, 3,500 feet of elevation.
We did a lot of climbing. We went up past Hamilton Lake, and then we came up through Precipice Lake, and then we hit Kaweah Gap at 10,700. That was a really tough day of climbing. We then came down a bit and found a nice spot along the river to camp at.
That was the first morning we came out with frost on our tent. Things were starting to freeze. Thermometer said it was 28 degrees.
Right as we're starting to make dinner, we were making grits and salami, peppered salami. Sunset's going down, and all of a sudden, a pack of coyotes start howling. Actually, I think one coyote started howling, and then another joined in, and then it sounded like there were 20 coyotes howling, and I've never been more scared in my life. I thought they were coming to attack because we had food.
Yeah, somebody answered that. Good morning!
Good morning!
It's cold!
We got up and we followed the trail. We did some climbing along this ridge. We hit a high point and then we started coming back down. We passed Moraine Lake and we ended up doing all the way down to Upper Funston Meadow. So this was a big downhill day. And then we were in a gorge here.
We're in the High Sierra Trail. Over 10,000 feet right now.
What day are we on?
Day three.
Of how many?
Seven.
We're not even halfway there. Woo! Yeah.
No turning back.
Nice to breathe at 10,000 feet. Been a good trip.
Because we've always had water wherever we were going. We could pump wherever we went, and we always, all the rivers were full of water, so we would put stop constantly and put our feet in the water, which was just such a nice rejuvenating thing. And every time we camped, we usually had water, so every time we got to camp, the first thing I did was put my feet in the water.
The campsite was great, and the meal was phenomenal. It's probably my favorite meal of the whole trip. Salmon with pesto sauce and spaghetti. Yeah, that was amazing. And on top of that, we made a fire that night, and the fire just was very nice to sit by, look at the stars, and it was very warm.
What is that you're cooking, Adam?
Fresh toasted Pop-Tart for Jennifer.
Yummy. Were we warm last night?
Oh, we were toasty warm and 38 degree shivering.
We followed the Kern River up past the hot springs, and we followed it all the way up all day along the riverbed until we hit Junction Meadow.
Really enjoyed the hike up the Kern River, day three. Beautiful trout. I would love to get back there sometime and do some serious trout fishing. Beautiful forest. Word of the day was tree.
We got to the Kern Hot Springs, which for me, that was total, it changed everything. It was like I started fresh on the trail.
How was the hot springs?
Oh, it was about as refreshing a bath as I've ever had.
Hi.
How we doing?
Day four. We're halfway.
Camp. We tried making like a little makeshift fishing pole out of some fishing gear I had brought and a little stick. We didn't catch anything, but it was really fun trying to fish.
Made another campfire. We had this huge fire ring. We were the only people at all these campsites. Nobody else was around, and it was like very much so in the middle of the wilderness. We were 36 miles either way out to get out from there, and so it just felt very isolated and quiet. And we woke up early. We did switchbacks uphill. We took the High Sierra Trail that we'd been following all the way across, and it met up with the Pacific Crest Trail and also the John Muir Trail. We came down a bit, came across to Crabtree, and then we climbed this last bit up to Guitar Lake. We started hiking out of the valley, and that was a really hard climb. We knew that would be a tough day.
Found a nice little stump to make a table out of. Got some tuna. We just came over a pass. We were looking for a creek bed to put our feet in, but they all seem very dry. We seem to be on the dry side of the mountain now. Luckily, we have a lot of water we've been carrying. Day five. Woo!
For lunch, let's see, we had tuna and hot sauce and carrots. We had some broccoli that lasted us the whole way, almost 5 days through.
Crabtree Station, 4.4. Mount Whitney, 11.7. That was like nothing.
We joined the Pacific Crest Trail and the John Muir Trail. And we started telling jokes. We usually had like a theme for the day, either like rock. And so every joke from rock would branch into like stone or pebble. Or the next day was a tree. So tree would be like leaf or sapling of some sort. And that was really fun. That was a good morale booster for us because that day was really difficult.
And then we did 1,000,000 switchbacks until we hit the trail that went to the summit. We summited Mount Whitney, 14,505. And then we came back down. We went out through trail camp. We went a little bit past it and kind of stayed the night on Consultation Lake.
Summit day, how are you feeling?
Wonderful. Beautiful morning, moonrise, moonset, great day.
Thank you.
You just summited Mount Whitney. What are you going to do next?
I am going to walk down from Mount Whitney, go to Lone Pine, and have a nice cold beer.
Sounds good. See you there.
All right. You're there. I'll buy.
There's your bird friend.
Yeah, look at this.
So did you have any doubts? You knew you'd make it the whole way.
I always had doubts. I'm not as young as I used to be, you know.
61.
61 and 363 days.
I mean, if you're counting like that, sure.
I don't know. You guys were kind to walk at my pace. I appreciate that.
Any advice for anyone who's going to climb Mount Whitney?
One step in front of the other.
What do you think of the view?
It is spectacular. I think it's tremendous.
Doesn't seem like we're at the highest though.
Hey.
Okay, what did Adam have to say?
Commentary?
I felt good not carrying the bag the last 2 miles. My back is forever changed, I think. Sour Patch Kids tastes really good. And
Adam just said, I don't feel like we're on the highest one. There are others that look higher.
I think we're there. Higher.
No, this one's got it by 2 feet.
Yeah. See, look.
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, close one.
Eating all the leftovers.
All the food.
Summited Mount Whitney. Woo!
Hardest thing today?
I did not like those really thin, rocky.
Where you had a boot?
Like cliff on the right and.
A boot width before you fell into
the
precipice?
Yeah, I could have done without that. I freaked myself out a little bit there today.
High point?
When I saw the roof at the top of Mount Whitney.
Yeah.
When I was inside the cabin, because the roof was still 15 minutes away.
M&M's at the top, yeah.
I don't think we realized quite how many switchbacks we had. There had to have been thousands of switchbacks, and at the time we didn't even know we were climbing Mount Whitney. From the back, it doesn't look like anything but a pile of sand. And so when we were switchbacking and we got to the top and it was like 1.9 miles, we were like, wow, we were climbing Mount Whitney and didn't even really know it.
On the way down, I felt totally fine on the way up. On the way down, I started feeling a little woozy and stuff. And then sleeping for the final night was very difficult for me. I woke up, my like sinuses were all clogged. I couldn't sleep. I was cold. On top of that, I woke up hoping it was like 5-6 in the morning and it was like 10:45. And that was horrible. Another night would have been just very difficult for me.
And then we hiked the 6 miles out to Whitney Portal the next morning.
We're on our way down a few miles from trail camp, or from the end, and I'm looking forward to a cheeseburger.
So here we sit at the end of the High Sierra Trail.
Glad it's over. Don't know if I'd do it again, but fun's not exactly the word to describe it, but rewarding definitely is.
7 days, about 15,000 feet of elevation gain, 13,000 feet of elevation loss, about 73 miles in 7 days.